before CrossFit, I was trying to do professional bodybuilding. So it, like I said, it was very, very regimented, you know, the strict, you know, two a days, and, you know, everything was on a schedule. So basically the complete opposite of CrossFit. You know, CrossFit's taking movements that we do every single day, like I said, you know, squatting, pressing, deadlifting, and bringing those into the context of the gym and teaching people to do those correctly and then applying those concepts to real life. You know, our gym model doesn't work on somebody paying a fee and never coming. You know, our gym model based on somebody coming in and getting better, getting fitter. I found out about CrossFit from a friend of mine. He was a West Pointer, and he was exposed to CrossFit when he was overseas. I'm sorry, when he got back from overseas. And he was moved here for a job, and I met him at another gym in town that I was attending at the time, and he introduced me to it, and we just picked it up and ran with it. When I got started with CrossFit, I mean, like so many people, I fell in love with it. And you know, we had only been doing CrossFit, I think, you know, 4 or 5 months, and you know, I got on CrossFit.com and looked, and there were only 2 affiliates in the state at that time. And I mean, it's like I love this. And we were kind of getting kicked out of the gym that we were at, which is kind of a normal within CrossFit to start their own affiliate. And that's how we got started. I mean, I saw that there was a need for it. A lot of people were really interested in it. So, I mean, we just jumped right on board with it. The CrossFit Open is kind of, it's an annual competition. It's kind of road to the CrossFit Games every single year. And the CrossFit Open is made for everybody in the world. So anybody in the world can sign up. And we have 5 workouts over 5 weeks. And at the end of the 5 weeks, basically the top 48 athletes from each region that have the best score cumulative across the 5 workouts advance to the regional competition. Gearing up for the Open, I mean, I was doing a lot of high volume. There were times that I was doing 2-a-days, basically 2 workouts a day. You know, sometimes it would be a strength and then a Metcon difference, and other times, you know, I'd have a workout and then, you know, a skill session, really trying to refine on the movements. It was just, I have a coach, so he was the one that was programming all that stuff for me. You know, honestly, I just kind of squeeze the workouts in, you know, when I can. You know, some days I don't have a strict regimen. You know, some days I may train at 6 a.m., you know, because that's the only time I have, and other days it may be 6 p.m. So it's just kind of finding that balance is kind of always, it's a balancing act. You just kind of got to go with the flow and then, you know, and fit it in when you can. There was roughly around 5,000 guys in our region. It's a very large region. It's comprised of 11 states. I placed 35th out of 48 in the North Central region, which is, you know, pretty, it, I was only from the state to do it. So, I mean, you know, that was kind of cool. But it's a big region. So that was pretty cool. A lot of people see the CrossFit Games, you know, on TV, and that's not CrossFit. You know, making elite athletes, the CrossFit Games is kind of just a very, very small part of CrossFit. You know, CrossFit is about people bettering their lives and people growing together and moving correctly. Typical classes are an hour long. Usually what we do, we have everybody come in and do, you know, everybody will do their own warm-up for about the first 5 minutes. After that, we do a group warm-up. Then we'll do actually applied skill section where, based on the workout that day, we'll pick one of the movements, and this is where we work kind of under the supervision of a coach and really work on kind of perfecting that movement, you know, addressing any mobility issues, anything like that that would come into play to help a person, you know, get better. Then, you know, if it's a barbell movement, at that point we'll start working under load, under the supervision of the coach, to find the load that we're going to use for the workout. Then everybody does the workout together, and then we usually have like a cash out that will revolve around, you know, auxiliary work like core, posterior chain, stuff like that. I have a skin condition called dermographia, and it's basically where my body doesn't produce any antihistamines. Antihistamines is what your body uses to fight infection in a lot of cases. So with, you know, before, you know, CrossFit and following, you know, the paleo diet is kind of the basic recommendations and where we start people. You know, I was sick all the time, you know, had walking pneumonia and several times, twice over 3 years, bronchitis, just, I was basically just sick 24/7, and made the switch to the paleo diet, and I haven't been sick since. And that's what, you know, CrossFit is about, is like I said, you know, kind of getting back to nature, eating real food, eating food that is minimally processed. CrossFit Kids is, again, like I said, we bring in the same elements of CrossFit. We just, you know, obviously we don't load them. The biggest thing is teaching the kids to move correctly. But more importantly than that, it's making fitness fun. You know, obviously, you know, with the obesity epidemic and type 2 diabetes being very prevalent in young, you know, younger and younger ages. I mean, it's just really important that, again, we have kids of this generation associate fitness with being fun and staying physically active. I think there's a lot of contributing factors that make it hard. We've got convenience, you know, food is right there. I mean, you can basically live your entire life and work from a couch and never, you know, and never have to leave it. I would say probably the biggest thing is the disease of choice. I mean, people wake up every day and they have a decision to make whether to better themselves or not, to be physically active or not. And people, most people choose not to. I was very skeptical of CrossFit at first, but give it a shot. I'm telling you, it has the potential to change your life. A lot of people see the CrossFit games, you know, on TV, and that's not CrossFit. You know, making elite athletes, the CrossFit games is kind of just a very, very small part of CrossFit. You know, CrossFit is about people bettering their lives and people growing together and moving correctly. So, I mean, if you're skeptical, I'd say definitely give it a shot. Most CrossFit boxes will be more than happy to let you try a couple workouts for free. CrossFit is for everybody. Not everybody's for CrossFit. What's great about the movements that we use in CrossFit is they have universal scalability. So, like squatting. Everybody has to squat to get off the toilet in the morning. So what makes that great is, again, we have people in here who are 65 years old. We've got some guys in here, they're pushing, over 300 pounds. And we've got a girl in spina bifida. And then we've got our fire breathers. So again, the program doesn't change, it just differs by degree. We take the person and build them up, based on their fitness level and where they're at that time.